Worldwide, and I thank God for your life and for getting set ready to listen to the atmosphere of faith. I believe that in this broadcast, the Lord is going to touch your life. Wherever you are, I want you to call your neighbor, I want you to call a friend, I want you to call somebody that Pastor Evans is here to minister life on Faith TV. And I believe that this evening also, God is going to minister a word in your life, in your situation. And I believe with every fiber of my heart that something is going to happen to you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, the Bible says that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. By the Word, all things were created. Wherefore, I believe that this evening also, God is going to create your life. God is going to manufacture something in your situation. I believe that God is going to make a door open for somebody under the sound of my voice. How, I may not tell, but I believe that my God is going to visit you. There is going to be a divine visitation tonight, and I believe that God will definitely bless you. Hallelujah. Now, within a few minutes we're going to spend together, I'm going to break and dissect the Word of God with you. I'm going to share the Word of God. I love the Word of God. I love it. I just love the Word of God. I'm going to break the Word of God down to your understanding. Now, your ability to understand the Word of God is key to victory. There is no way you can succeed in life without understanding. Understanding is the ability to divert words into pictures and to visualize the picture. And whatsoever you see, you believe. And what you believe is what you become. I believe that somebody is going to become blessed tonight. I believe that also. I don't know what you seems to go through in your life, but I've come to you by the power of God with an answer that wherever you are, there is going to be a visitation. Hallelujah. Praise Him, the Lord. I want to pray with you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for my brother's life. I thank you for my sister's life in Jesus' name. I pray that tonight also you will share a word with somebody. I pray that miracles will be made manifest in their lives. I pray for healing. I pray for signs and wonders. I ask that there will be divine visitation in the name of Jesus. Glory and honor be unto your holy name. In Jesus' name have we prayed. Amen. Amen. Now, precious one, I am Pastor Evans upon City of Faith Ministries. As shown on the screen, our church is in Barkin, number 6 Thames Road, Barkin. Hallelujah. Now, every Thursday also, our branch in Enfield, 7 p.m. on Thursdays at the Vicent House, takes place every Thursday. And on every Tuesday also, our branch in Stevenage, Kirkstuff. Hallelujah. I believe that you will meet me in any of these areas and to be a blessing to you and to share the word of God in your life and in your situation. Amen. Now tonight I want to share with you about breaking the horns of the enemy. Breaking every demonic horns in your life. Amen. If you care to know, I want you to open your Bible to the book of Zechariah chapter number 1 from the verse number 18. Zechariah chapter 1 from verse number 18. I read, "Then I lifted up my eyes and saw, and behold, four horns. And I said unto the angel that walked and talked with me, What be these? And he answered me, These are the horns which have scattered Judah, Israel, and Jerusalem. And the Lord showed me four carpenters." Now I'm going to read further. Now the Bible says that, "And I lifted up my eyes and I saw four horns. And I asked the angel of God that talked to me, What are these? And the angel of the Lord said to me, These are the horns that have scattered Judah, Israel, and Jerusalem." Now, ladies and gentlemen, one thing you must begin to understand is whenever the Bible makes mention of a horn is a defensive mechanism. The horn is the resistance also. Now, a horn can be for defense. A horn can also be for resistance. A horn can be a limitation. Anytime an animal begins to lift up the horn, it is trying to defend itself. It is also trying to protect and fight against. Now, the Bible says that, and Zechariah the prophet said, I lifted up my eyes and God showed me four horns. I believe that the horns were the north, the south, the east, and the west. Now, these are horns that have prevailed against Israel. They have prevailed against Judah. They have prevailed against Jerusalem. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I came here to share some revelation with you. And I believe that by the grace of God, your understanding will be open. And I believe that God is going to show you a mystery in your life, that you begin to know that it is not just by chance that things happen. Now, the Bible says that the horns have been lifted. That is the key. The horns have been lifted. Now, the horns are there to fight against Judah. The horns are there to fight against Israel. And the horns are there to fight against Jerusalem. Now, Judah means praise. In other words, adoration. In other words, joy. In other words, blessings. In other words, peace. Now, Judah means that praise. And the Bible says that the horns of the enemy were lifted against the praise of God's people. In other words, anything that is meant to bring joy in the life of God's people were being fought against. Now, I don't know who is listening to me right now. There are times in your life your Judah have been fought against. Every now and then, when it looks like something is coming your way that will make you glorify God, that will make you praise God, something coming your way in order for you to laugh, something coming your way in order for the battle to be over, all of the sudden something happened and you don't seem to understand. But the Bible says that there is a horn that prevailed against Judah. In other words, these are horns that have been lifted against your praise. But I came as a prophet of the Most High God and to declare in your life and your situation that every prevailed horn against your joy, against your blessings, against your peace, against your marriage, I declare, may the sword of Jehovah cut every demonic horn in the name of Jesus. Now, the Bible says these are the horns that have prevailed against Judah. I don't know where your Judah may be. Your Judah may be your marriage. Your Judah may be your job. Your Judah may be your finances. Your Judah may be your promotion. Whatever is the Judah in your life that the enemy is fighting against it, I employ the sword of Jehovah and I command a release in your life in Jesus' mighty name. I declare that tonight, by the power of the Almighty, the sword of Jehovah shall cut you through. You will break through. You will excel. You will see the glory of the Lord in the land of the living. These are the horns that have been lifted against Judah. Child of God, I come your way today in the name of Jesus. I don't care what the enemy is doing. I don't care the plans of wickedness. I don't care what the enemy wants to do and has been done, the curses and the covenant in your life. I come to command a deliverance in your life. You have been a Christian for a long time. You have been a believer. You give your tithe. You go to church. But nothing seems to work in your life. Your Judah is fought against. Your Judah is battled against. But I came to declare, may the horn of the enemy be broken of your life in the name of Jesus. I hear the Bible says, thou, O Lord, shall exalt my horn. May your horn be lifted. May your name be glorified. May your destiny be changed. May God transform your life. I declare that this year your marriage will come to pass. I declare that this year you will excel. I declare that you will be established in the name of Jesus. Now, these are the horns. Now, sometimes in your life, you don't understand why you go to the north. Nothing seems to work. You turn back, there is nothing working. All the people you began life with are better than you. They have gone way ahead of you. And nothing seems to work with you. But I came to the declare there is a God in heaven. God has engaged me today to break every satanic horn, every occultic horn, every witches and wizard, every power, every manipulation.